Beyond the current spending fight, beyond the current economic climate, Democrats are facing a potentially tougher challenge with voters in the year ahead. These headlines underscore the party hemorrhaging support from rural white voters. And last week's results in Virginia really driving home just how serious the problem has become. In NBC News exit polling, Republican Glenn Youngkin blew Democrat Sarah McAuliffe out of the water, winning nearly two-thirds of rural voters. Youngkin actually even beat former President Trump's margins with that particular group, rural voters from the 2020 presidential race, by 11 points. This is clearly a warning sign for Democrats heading into next year's midterms. But the answer could lie with Democrats who've had success in rural areas. Joining me now, someone who's done just that, former Democratic Governor of Montana, Steve Bullock, who is now the co-chair of American Bridge 21st Century. Governor, always good to have you. And when it's
great
comes
to be with
to,
you, Greg.
Thank you. When it comes to potential reasons for why Democrats are losing rural support, you told the New York Times, quote, folks don't feel like we're offering them anything or hearing or listening to them. Explain what you mean.
Yeah, and look, Virginia certainly is part of the wake-up call with 45 counties where Youngkin won by over 70%. But if you look over the last decade, you just had someone on from Arkansas. We used to have a Democratic senator in Arkansas, in Louisiana. We've lost senators in Montana, North Dakota, South Dakota, 10 all over. And to me, what it really means is, look, first, we got to show up in rural areas. We've got to listen. And you got to recognize that the challenges that people face and often what they're voting on are those same issues that they're talking about at their kitchen table. Do I have a decent job? Do I have a roof over my head? Is my community safe? Do I have clean air, clean water? Can I believe that I can do better for my kids and grandkids myself? And unfortunately, for half of America, and that's urban and rural, that hasn't been the case over the last decades.
Is that because many Democratic candidates, or maybe even the party's message at large, is now one that's designed to appeal more to those urban and suburban voters at the expense of rural voters?
Well, and I think that's where we've really got to make sure that our message, the Democratic Party message, is one that can work in urban and rural areas. Like, I've gone to small towns where literally the closest child care center is 30 miles away. There's 9 infants and toddlers for every 1 child care slot in rural America. Look at child care and pre-K. It's important in urban areas. It's important in rural areas. Healthcare, we got Medicaid expansion passed. I didn't talk about it as Obamacare or as entitlement. I went to every single rural hospital, and folks recognized if you lose that hospital, you're going to lose that town. You're going to lose, you know, the small businesses in them. So it's not, you know, it's, look, we've got to make sure that our message is one. If you look at both the infrastructure bill and Build Back Better, it has those constituent pieces that matter in rural America as well as mattering in urban America. And what we've got to make sure that we're doing is, look, we often don't even, as Democrats, we don't show up in those hard places. We don't even listen to say, what are the challenges that you're facing? And we need to start doing that.
You mentioned the Build Back Better bill, the infrastructure bill, the hard infrastructure bill that the president's expected to sign on Monday. There's $65 billion that's set aside for improving broadband nationwide. Congressman Jim Clyburn has spent a lot of time talking about how crucial that is going to be, especially for rural America. But you don't hear Democrats, at least maybe it's just me, I don't hear a lot of Democrats out there selling that part of the plan to rural America. Billions of dollars in broadband infrastructure.
No, Craig, that's exactly right. And we need to be talking about that, right? In a 21st century economy, you have to have connectivity if you're actually going to be able to succeed. And in so many parts of this country, largely rural, but some in urban, we don't have that. Or when one of every 5 road miles is in disrepair and you have to go a long way to get there, it's not only the jobs will be created, but it's the opportunity. So I do think that that is part of exactly the issue, is there's great stuff in there. And there's important things for rural America as well as urban America. And we need to make sure that we're talking to both. Let's talk about what actually unifies us. Let's talk about housing. You know, there's 1 in 4 Americans in rural areas pay over half of their income for rental housing. You need housing in rural areas just like you do in urban. Homes are where jobs go to sleep at night. So we need to start actually, and it's part of it certainly messaging, and part of it's also recognizing that, yeah, there's maybe a lot of counties that you don't win, but that doesn't mean that you write off those areas or you don't listen to those areas. And I think we as a party, and that's not just Virginia and New Jersey, as I know that that's what we've seen over the last decade when it comes to Senate races, we've got to do better in doing that.
Former Governor of Montana, Steve Bullock. Governor, thank you. Always good to see you. Thanks for your insights, sir. Enjoy your weekend.